All right. Concept 2 in charging section 9.1. Please always remember the charging section language. What was the language of 9.1? First few words. Levy. Section 9.1. Levy. On? All intrastate supply of goods or services or both except alcoholic liquor for human consumption. Hold here. That levy is on India. Levy is on India. See, obviously Indian Act cannot be levied in Canada and other countries. Yes. That's why I told you extent of law is whole of India. Now you understand what do you mean by India. Am I clear? What do you mean by India? India means India landmass. It can further it can extend up to 12 nautical mile, that is territorial water of India. It can be further extended up to 200 nautical mile, that is known as exclusive economic zone. This is what concept one we had discussed. Now the language is intrastate supply. CGST and AGST is applicable on intrastate supply. Sir, unfortunately, intrastate supply is not defined in CGST and AGST Act. Charge is on intrastate supply. That means they should define what is intrastate, isn't it? But unfortunately, it is not defined in CGST and AGST. It is defined next to where interstate has been defined. Okay? And interstate chargeability will come on under which act? IGST Act. And therefore, here you can see interstate supply is defined under section 7 of IGST Act, not CGST. Section 7 of IGST Act 2017, there itself, after defining what is interstate, they had defined intrastate. Okay, so this is section 8 of not CGST but IGST. Will you keep it in mind now? Because it is not in CGST Act, it is in IGST Act. Okay, sir, what is intrastate? There are two conditions, you can see two conditions on my board. Location of supplier and place of supply should be in same state or same UT. Same state or same UT. Okay, then only it is known as intrastate supply. Okay, same state or same union territory, then only it is intrastate supply. You can see location of recipient is not relevant. Place of supply is relevant. Hello. Now you are from, Maharashtra. I am from Maharashtra. So it is intrastate. You understand? Location is here. Location of service is this, Jogeshwari. And this is in Maharashtra. Okay? Place of supply is also Maharashtra. But this guy, he is from Kerala. So whatever our sections I am teaching to him now, is interstate or intrastate? Intrastate. Why? Because location of supplier, this is my location, and place of supply. Right now services are happening here. Hello. That's why it is intrastate. Although his location is somewhere else. So your location doesn't matter. Your location doesn't matter. Recipient location doesn't matter. Place of supply matters. You understand? Okay. So location of supplier and place of supply, if this is in same state or same UT, then this is intra. Can you define inter for me, sir? Inter for me. What will they write? Sir, where? Tell me. Where? Location of supplier, that is LOS, we will call it LOS, and place of supply, that is POS, are in, can you tell me, different state or different union territories, or come on, tell me, different state, different union territory, or a state and a UT. Hello. One state to another state, one UT to another UT, one UT to state, a state to UT, this is interstate. Okay, where supply, commencement of supply and termination of supply, commencement of supply and termination of supply is located in different state, different UT, or a state or UT, is interstate supply. If both are located in same state, then only it is intrastate. Now second unfortunate thing is that you don't have these things in your syllabus. Okay, this is the core of GST, place of supply. Okay, IPCC does not have this particular part in our syllabus. There are more than 44 different situations that we have to buy at CA final, but right now these things are not there in our syllabus. Am I clear? Yeah, so for us only general understanding is enough. If commencement of supply and termination is in same state, intra. Commencement and termination is in different state, inter. Okay, write it down.